Good morning. In the last lecture, we talked about probability current. Now, let us switch to the next article. Expectation. Let us see what is meaning of this expectation model. We know Schrodinger equation is written for a particle in motion. When a particle is in motion in quantum mechanics, it is always associated with a wave function, and so the Schrodinger equation is written using the wave functions. So whenever we talk of any body or any particle in motion, we always write Schrodinger equation for that particle. We want to have information about various physical quantities associated with the particle in motion. To know various physical quantities associated with the particle in motion, what we need to know is the wave function for the particle which is in motion. And how to get the wave function? Just solve the Schrodinger equation. How to solve the Schrodinger equation? To solve this Schrodinger equation, you need to know the potential energy of the particle. Maybe function of x or xy z. Function of x in one dimension. Function of xy z in three dimensions. Knowing this, we can solve the Schrodinger equation. And we can have the wave function for the particle in motion. Once we got the equation for the wave function of the particle in motion, we can use this wave function for describing any physical quantity of that particle. In quantum mechanics, some of the physical quantities of the particle in motion may be quantized. Others may not be quantized. The physical quantities corresponding to the particle in motion, which are quantized, these physical quantities can be specified in terms of specific numbers by using the wave function of the particle in motion. But the other physical quantities which are not quantized will be restricted by the uncertainty principle. And specification of the physical quantities which are restricted by the uncertainty principle could not be specified in terms of specific numbers. We can specify these physical quantities in terms of probabilities instead of the specific numbers. This is the problem using quantum mechanics. For simplicity, let us suppose that we want to specify expectation value for position of particles. We want to specify expectation value for position of particles. These particles are taken in motion. As these particles are in motion, every particle will be associated with certain wave function. For simplicity, let me assume that all the particles in motion under consideration are specified by a single wave function. But I am assuming for simplicity, all the particles under consideration which are in motion are specified, are associated with a single wave function. If large particles are there, they are in motion, and you are asked to find average position of these, what do we do? We shall measure position of every particle at certain xt from certain reference, and then we shall go for the average. For simplicity, let us suppose that there are n1 number of particles about position x1 from the given reference. N2 number of particles are about the position x2 from the reference under consideration. N3 number of particles are at x3, are at position x3 from the given reference, and so on. This can be done. Then x bar, average position for these particles will be average position of the particles may be given by this equation. X bar is equal to summation over I n I x I divided by summation over I n I. We may call this is the expectation value of the position. We can use equations of type equation 1. If the particles are large enough, let us suppose that you have a single particle which is in motion and you are asked to find expectation value of position on this one, where height xi within the interval dx. Then it will be represented by the probability PR is equal to square root modulus of your function into dx, the interval within which x bar is to be. More specific way to represent this may be let me replace this assumption by integration so that I may put this x bar equal to equation 2 is just similar to equation 1. Not identical, but identical. Okay. This is written in terms of integration. What is meaning of integration in the denominator? Meaning of integration in the denominator is, it is the probability density of finding a particle in the space within the limit minus infinity to plus infinity. It is formed by making use of wave function of the particle in motion. If the wave function is normalized, if the wave function is normalized, it means that the probability density of finding a particle in motion in space from the limit minus infinity to plus infinity is definite, and that is equal to 1. It means that the particle in motion is there in the space somewhere. It is definite, and therefore that probability is equal to 1. So if we do the normalization, normalization of the wave function, denominator of equation 2 will be 1. As denominator of equation 2 becomes 1, expectation value of position x bar may now be written as, x bar is equal to integration of minus infinity to plus infinity dx, square of number of psi dx, equation 3. The reason is because of normalization of the function, the denominator has become, because of normalization of the wave function, this denominator has become 1, and therefore we can have x bar is equal to integration of minus infinity to plus infinity x into square of modulus of psi dx, since this is wave function normalized, and therefore the probability density of finding a particle in motion in a space from limit minus infinity to plus infinity is always definite, and that is equal to, this x bar is always appearing at the center of mass of square of modulus of psi. This x bar always appears at the center of mass of square of modulus of psi. Let us see what is meaning of this, the expectation value of the position of a particle in motion appears at the center of mass of square of modulus of the wave function of the particle in motion. For that purpose, you may plot a graph between x and this square of modulus of psi. Particle is not stationary, it is in motion, so x is not constant. X is changing continuously, note those values of x. As particle is moving, psi, the wave function, is associated with the particle. Find the value of the wave function psi when the particle moves from one place to other, and so on. Tabulate values of x and corresponding psi, and then plot a graph between x and modulus of square of modulus of the wave function psi. You will get certain type of curve. cut the graph between x axis corresponding to the position on x axis, we are going to take the position of the particle in motion at different times, at different instant of times, and on y axis we are going to take corresponding values of psi as square of modulus of psi. Cut the graph paper between the x axis and the curve obtained for square of modulus of psi, and then balance the graph paper which is cut. The point where the graph balances is corresponding to x bar, and it is known as expectation value of position of the particle in motion. More convenient way of writing equation 3 for expectation value of the position is this: x bar is equal to integration of the limits minus infinity to plus infinity psi s psi star dx, equation number 4. This is the more convenient and proper way of writing the expression for expectation value of a position of a particle fixed in motion. Here we have taken one physical quantity associated with the particle in motion. You can go for other physical quantities. You can go for energy. You can go for momentum. You can go for potential energy. Many parameters are there, many physical quantities are there, which are associated with the particle in motion. And you can find any of these by making use of the wave function of that particle. That will be the expectation value for the total energy. That may be the expectation value for the potential energy. That may be the expectation value for the kinetic energy. That may be the expectation value for the position, that may be the expectation value for the momentum, and so on. In general, if we have any physical quantity whose expectation value you wanted to find for the particle in motion, this is written in general as G of x bar, expectation bar for expectation value of physical quantity. It may be P of x, it may be P of xt, it may be Q of xt, it may be P of xt, it may be total energy, anything. This parameter, this physical quantity, may be any physical quantity related with the particle in motion. And the expectation value of any physical quantity related with the particle in motion in general can be found by using this equation. G of x is equal to integration within the limits minus infinity to plus infinity psi g of x psi star dx, equation number 5. This way we can find expectation value for any physical quantity associated with the particle in motion. And what do we need to have for this purpose? while starting this article, I told you that whenever a body or a particle is in motion, it is always associated with a wave function. We can write a Schrödinger equation for that particle, for that body which is in motion. We can know its potential energy. V of x or V of x vector. We can also know its total energy. We can know its kinetic energy. We can know its momentum. Provided that you have to solve the Schrödinger equation of that particle in motion, of that body in motion. Then solve Schrödinger equation for that particle in motion and get the wave function. Once we get the wave function after solving the Schrödinger equation for the particle in motion, this wave function gives us information about any physical quantity related with the particle. If the physical quantity which is to be specified, which is to be determined, is quantized, it can be expressed, it can be specified in terms of a specific number by making use of the wave function. But if the physical quantity to be explained, to be specified, to be determined is not quantized, it is restricted by the uncertainty principle, in that case the corresponding physical quantity for the particle in motion will be specified in terms of probability, not in terms of specific number. I have derived small equations, small part for this article, taking example for expectation value of the equation. This can be done for, we got this formula. This formula can be used for finding the expectation value of any physical quantity, provided that the wave function for the particle should be normalized. Normalized wave function is this one. If we have the probability density of a particle in motion is finite, is equal to 1, that wave function is normalized wave function. It is integration till limits minus infinity to plus infinity square of modulus of psi dx is equal to 1. If this is true, the wave function will be normalized, and if it will normalize, you can use equations like phi and can get expectation value for any physical quantity. Hope you got it. In the next lecture, we shall meet with the new article. Thank you.